The Pacific island nation of Tonga tonight remains cut off from the world, with the full impact of a devastating tsunami still not fully known. It follows the eruption of an underwater volcano about 65 kilometres north of Tonga's capital. The force enough for tsunami warnings to reach Australia, with the effects felt as far away as the United States.
Even from space, the scope of the eruption was stupendous. On Tonga, it sounded as bad as it looked.
Holy sh**!
Deafening, and for those by the water, it could only mean one thing: run.
Oh,
this is why. A tsunami generated by an underwater volcanic shockwave. New Zealand's High Commission provided high ground and a view for those who could flee there. But Tonga is relatively flat. Homes were flooded, cars were swept away, property destroyed, boats capsized. But given the ferocity of the multiple blasts, the tsunami itself was relatively small.
As yet, there are no official reports of injuries or deaths in Tonga.
The volcanic blast speared the tsunami across the Pacific. On Lord Howe Island, 50 people were evacuated to higher ground as warnings were issued in Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria and down to Tasmania. Thousands of kilometres of coast on alert.
Please come off the beach now.
Australia's Tongan community held church services this morning.
So far we haven't been able to contact our family at all.
Yesterday was our last conversation.
Pallets of humanitarian relief supplies out of our Brisbane warehouse are on their way.
The tsunami affected millions. The South Pacific Islands, New Zealand, Japan, racing past Hawaii to pound Canada, the US West Coast.
Oh my God!
And pushing thousands of kilometres south to Chile. The blasts were heard as far away as New Zealand and Fiji. The McCarthy family is on a Fiji holiday. They say the buildings shook even there.
We didn't know if there was war games, whether there was explosions going off in the Pacific.
New Zealand's Air Force wants to deploy to Tonga but cannot. The 19-kilometre-high volcanic plume is higher than its planes can even fly. Now, those humanitarian supplies sent from Brisbane to Ambley Air Force Base include enough shelter for 100 families of five. They will be loaded onto a C-130 with the hope it can take off for Tonga tomorrow. I say hope because so much depends on how much of the volcanic cloud has dissipated. An RAAF P-8 surveillance aircraft is also planning to fly over those smaller islands closer to the volcano, with fears those Tongan villages have been swamped not only by the tsunami but also by toxic ash and pumice falling from the sky. Communication with those islands has been severely compromised by a submarine cable which has been damaged by the eruption.
Robert Ovadia there. Let's bring in Caitlin Steadman now. And Queensland's coast saw extremely dangerous conditions as a result of this tsunami.
Katrina, unusual tides ripped across the coast with swells almost 1 metre high. The state surf lifesavers remain on high alert, with the Weather Bureau warning the risk of another eruption is possible as the impact of this is felt among Queensland's own Tongan community.
The enormity of the explosion sounding an alarm more than 3,000 kilometres away on Queensland's coast. Police telling swimmers to get out of the water and away from the ocean's edge. The tsunami warning stretching from Fraser Island to Point Danger at the border and further south into New South Wales. At first light, beaches remained closed, but surfers took the risk in dangerous conditions.
There's a lot of water moving, especially underneath the surface, but some good waves, definitely worth the paddle, but you wouldn't want to do it unless you're fairly experienced and fairly fit.
Strong rips and unusual sweeps swirling, swells reaching almost a metre on the Gold Coast. At 9:30, the warnings lifted. The red and yellow flags returned tourists as well.
Swimming outside the flags is incredibly dangerous.
As the warning was lifted and crowds returned to local beaches, our Tongan community came together anxiously awaiting any form of contact with friends and family back home.
in Sunnybank, the epicentre of hope. Members of the world's Tongan community calling into this radio station, sharing stories, praying, hoping, relying on their faith.
I guess when it happened, every Tongan all over the globe, just tears, was just filled with, swelled with tears.
A global vigil will last for days. Reverend Jason Gioa and his wife Fotolina beacons for their fellow Tongans.
It keeps us going, holding, knowing that we're holding each other in our prayers and in our thoughts and in our hearts.
Toa Late hasn't heard from her mother, brother or extended family. It's the unknown that's most challenging.
Anxiety and worry just, just overtook me.
Some were on the phone to their family when the huge waves hit.
They could just hear the screaming and the frightening of their loved ones. So it's a trial time for us Tongans.
This vigil, vital as they hold on to hope. Caitlin Steadman, 7 News.